हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई वंस अगेन वेलकम यू टू दिस सेशन ऑफ रेफ्रिजरेशन एंड एयर कंडीशनिंग। इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस द वर्किंग ऑफ द आइस प्लांट। नाउ एज यू कैन सी इन दिस स्लाइड वी हैव द पिक ऑफ द आइस फॉर्मेशन एंड यू कैन क्लियरली सी that the formation of ice in domestic refrigerator and that in the ice plant is quite different. The ice found in the domestic refrigerator, which is found generally in the tray, is of very small size, whereas the ice which is produced at the ice plant, okay, which are meant for commercial purposes, okay, as you can see in the pic itself that the size and the quantity are very very large. Okay, so as I discussed with you a while ago that the ice size in domestic refrigerator, okay, is very low as mentioned over here on the right hand side in the text. Okay, whereas in an ice plant we have the size of this ice formation is comparatively very very large. Okay, so difference as you can see over here that for forming the ice at such a large quantity of large size, we require separate circuit for cooling of the refrigerant which is used for making of the ice. Okay, and we have again another fluid which is moving, or refrigerant which is moving inside the vapor compression refrigeration system. Okay, now the refrigerant used in ice plants are, first one we have ammonia. Ammonia is used as a primary refrigerant. Okay, and we discussed in unit 3 that primary refrigerants are those which directly take part in the refrigeration or the cooling process. Okay, so here the ammonia is the primary refrigerant which takes heat from the brine, which is nothing but a salt solution. Okay, and ammonia which is moving inside the vapor compression refrigeration system changes its phase from liquid to vapor or vapor to liquid, okay, in a evaporator and condenser respectively. Okay, and we have the reasons of using ammonia in the ice plant. First of all is, you know that it is the refrigerant which has the highest value of the latent heat of vaporization. Okay, so this is one of the prime reason for using the ammonia in the ice plant. Okay, ammonia does not contain any chlorine and fluorine, you know. Okay, so that's why it has zero ozone depletion potential, and then also it has low value of GWP, that is global warming potential. Okay, and then since the seals are used in the pipings of the ice plant, the ammonia which is used is non-corrosive. Okay, and the boiling point, you know, of ammonia is very very less, so that's why it produces very low temperature which is required for formation of the ice. Okay, now the second refrigerant which is used in the ice plant is the brine. Okay, and it is known as the secondary refrigerant because it takes heat from the water which is to be converted into ice. Okay, and it exchanges the heat with the ammonia. Okay, so it acts as a it transport media between the ammonia and the water. So why we are using the brine as a secondary refrigerant? Okay, as I told you in the previous units, that is unit number 3, while discussing on the refrigerant, that when you add salt to the water, that is when you add NaCl or calcium chloride to the salt, as a salt to the water, then the freezing point of the water is lowered. Okay, and then you can easily exchange heat with the water. Okay, and water gets easily converted into ice. Okay, so all in all, brine increases the heat transfer rate between itself and the water. Okay, now there are 3 main circuits in an ice plant. Okay, first one we have the refrigeration circuit, right? So this is the circuit where we have the 4 main components of the vapor compression refrigeration system. Okay, and ammonia moving in the main components of the vapor compression refrigeration system, that is compressor, condenser, throttling device, and then finally evaporator. Okay, and in these devices, as you know already, that ammonia changes its phase alternatively from liquid to vapor and vapor to liquid. Okay, then second circuit is the cooling water circuit, which is used to take away the heat which is rejected at the condenser. Okay, so we have another one, cooling water circuit. I will show you these 3 different circuit in the next slide. Okay, and then the last one we have the brine circuit. Okay, so as I discussed in the previous slide, that brine is used as a secondary refrigerant. Okay, so brine takes the heat from the water. Okay, and in turn it exchanges with the ammonia. Okay, so this is how the ice is formed in a ice plant. Okay, right? So here, as you can see, we have a schematic diagram of the commercial ice plant, right? So here at the bottom you can see where we have a large storage tank where the ice cans are kept. Okay, and from this ice can we have the ice in the form of large slab which is coming out. Okay, so here, as you can see from the pic at the right hand side, we have the large block of the ice which are coming outside from the cans. Okay, and these cans, as I told you, are kept in a large tank. Okay, and inside which we have the brine solution. Okay, and the level of the brine here inside this storage tank is greater than the level of the water which is kept inside this, you can say, cans, which contains the potable water which is required to be converted into ice. Okay, so here again, as I told you in the previous slide, that we have 3 circuits. So first is refrigerating circuit, which is shown by the dot and the arrow. Okay, and it is circulating in the main refrigeration circuit. Okay, as you can see over here. Okay, as you can see here, we have the low temperature, low pressure ammonia vapor entering into the compressor. Okay, and then after compressing, the ammonia which is at higher pressure and higher temperature condition moves into condenser. Okay, in condenser, the ammonia rejects heat, gets converted into liquid from vapor phase. Okay, and then it again enters into the evaporator via receiver and throttling valve. Okay, so receiver, as you know, maintains the level of refrigerant in the refrigeration circuit, and we have the throttle valve which is used to expand the refrigerant from high pressure to lower pressure. Okay, And finally, as you can see here, we have the refrigerant now in the liquid form, basically entering into the evaporator, because the heat transfer requirement in the evaporator or the cooling load in the evaporator is very, very high. That's why the desire for the evaporator is of, you can say, or the requirement is of the liquid refrigerant completely. Okay, so this is about the refrigerant circuit. The next one, we have the cooling water circuit. As you can see, when the this is, as you can see, we have the cooling circuit, we have the pump, the water tank, the natural cooling tower, and then again pump, as you can see at the bottom. Okay, so when the heat is rejected, the water from the cooling tower is supplied through the pump into the condenser. Okay, so this water takes away the heat of the condenser. Okay, and by means of the pump, it is supplied to the water tank at the top. Okay, and we have the natural cooling tower. So water drops here by gravity, and then the air is allowed to enter from the side, as you can see over here. Okay, so direct contact between the water and the air takes place. Air takes away the heat of the water and cool it. Okay, and cold water again collected at the bottom, and then again it is recirculated back into the condenser for cooling purpose. Okay, and then the last one, we have the branch circuit, as you can see over here. Here we have the evaporator and then brine coming from the evaporator going into the storage tank, okay, or the large tank, and then again it is pumped by means of the brine pump back into the evaporator. Okay, so as you can see over here, the brine is used to take the coolness of the ammonia from the evaporator, that is brine supplying the heat to the ammonia for converting into vapor from the liquid state. Okay, so the brine entering into the form of low temperature over here. Okay, and then it enters into this storage tank. Right here you can see that the heat transfer between the water kept inside the ice can and the brine takes place. Okay, and water gets converted into ice and the temperature of the brine rises up. Okay, again this brine is supplied by means of brine pump back to the evaporator, as you can see over here. Okay, so this brine again circulates over back to the storage tank. Okay, so this is how you can see we have the separate circuit of the brine. Okay, so this is the all about the working of the commercialized plant. Okay, and for more understanding of the working of the ice plant, I am sharing the animation link with you. Okay, so this is the animation link as shown in your slide. Okay, so you can just click on it and see it on a YouTube how the ice plant easily works. Okay, so I hope you understood the working of the ice plant. Okay, thank you.